Ladies and gentlemen, guys and gals, on location again today, right here, up to number 269. Who would have thunk we'd make it all this way? On location at the Alsatian Wine Festival up in Mendocino. Today we're going to get into the Cuvee A, the Anne Amie 2008 Muller Thurgau from the Willamette Valley, straight out of Oregon. Here we are, people. Thanks for coming out. We're here, special guest, Thomas Houseman. What's going on, my friend?
We have music.
Look at that.
Oysters. We have Muller Thurgau.
Phenomenal. This is the bottle that we're tasting here, people. Check it out. This is the label you're going to want to look for. How about 3D? You don't think that's 3D? That's 3D. No glasses necessary. And there we go. There's the Alsatian wine glass, making it happen. Look out for this glass. Thomas, what can you tell me about Muller Thurgau?
Well, the great thing about Muller Thurgau is that it's the underdog. There used to be a lot of Muller Thurgau in the United States, in Sauvignon Blanc, in New Zealand. It was Muller Thurgau. They ripped it out, they planted Sauvignon Blanc. Now you know Marlboro Sauvignon Blanc, you've never heard of Muller Thurgau. Yeah, we grow 10 acres of Muller Thurgau. We're the largest contiguous block of Muller Thurgau in North America.
Awesome. Look at that. Booyah. And we got some in the glass here. What's the concept, I think? What's going on with Anne Amie?
Well, Anne Amie is basically, Anne Amie is about making wines that are about food. Everybody says that. But
you mean it.
My job is to not get in the way of stuff.
Excellent. So I understand you're a dancer. We got some music. What's going on? The robot?
Yeah.
There we go. We're making it happen. So we got this wine in our glass. The color on it is really beautiful. You know, it's nice, light body as far as the color is concerned. I get a touch of a yellow kind of golden hue, and the light just dances off the top of the glass. You're not wasting any time. We're getting into the nose of this wine. Thomas, what are we smelling here?
For me, it's kind of a... what would this be?
A whole lot of that? That's that exotic fruit.
Yeah, but,
you know, I get touches of lychee in this one. I get some green apple coming out of it.
Kaffir lime leaves.
Kaffir lime, people.
Yeah, you know kaffir lime.
Yeah, who doesn't know kaffir lime?
It's my food, baby.
It's just beautiful. So we've looked at this wine, we've smelled this wine, and everybody out there that watches, you know what time it is. I'm going to say it's monkey time. There it is. It's monkey time for all of you. Thomas is going to say it's what time?
It's Muller time.
It's Muller time. Let's make it happen. Hello, rock and roll. It's yummy. There's a really nice underlying minerality that goes along with it. If you were going to pair this up with some food, what would you be eating?
Cambodian. Yeah, something like fish en moque. Something like some coconut milk, lemongrass, ginger. You know, it's got the acidity to cut through that, but it's got that wonderful thing with Asian food made of jasmine rice.
Yummy. Good stuff. And if people wanted to get in touch with you, do you all have a website you can send them to?
Yeah, it's pretty easy. www.anamie.com. So
www.anamie.com.
Exactly.
That's the one. Well, Thomas, thanks a lot for taking the time. It was a pleasure tasting the wine.
Knock
them dead. It's Muller time. And every day you're looking for a Taste Along webisode, you know where to find it. Check out AdamTheWineGuy.com. Today, we made it all the way up to number 269, Anne Amie, Cuvee A, Muller Thurgau, 2008, straight out of the Willamette Valley. Booyah.